All right, guys, gonna be doing a quick little video on the Leatherman Surge. I've had this guy for about 2 months now. Figured I'd do a little first impressions, basically, because it is fairly new to me. Just show you guys my thoughts, tell you guys my thoughts, show you guys the Leatherman. So, obviously, like I said, this is the Leatherman Surge. It is a very heavy-duty workhorse, as the website says. That is all true. This is a very heavy-duty, awesome tool. So on the outside, you got your blade. You got some very, very useful scissors. The most useful scissors I've ever seen on a Leatherman. That cutting edge is, I'd say, about an inch or so. But very large scissors, very useful. You got your serrated blade. And last but not least, your file. And this is interchangeable with the saw blade. I got the saw blade right here. Comes in this little pouch. I do wish they could have integrated either the file or the saw on the inside, so you could have both these running at once. In my experience so far, whichever one is not in here, I tend just to go grab another tool to complete the task. You know, it's pretty simple to change it, but by the time you have to get this out, open this mechanism up, swap the blades, put the other one in the case, put that one away, it just seems easier to grab something else. So it would have been nice if they could have integrated that somewhere. For me, I would have liked to see that on the inside, maybe where the can opener is. We'll go over these inside tools here, like right here. If I'd prefer if the file was on the inside, the saw was on the outside, or yeah, I guess, yeah, that'd probably be the best. But for me, can opener, bottle opener are pretty useless items on this particular tool. I would not be carrying this tool hiking, maybe around a campsite. Well, probably. But other than that, I would not carry this on any hiking or hunting trips. It's just way too heavy. So that would be awesome. And even at that, even if I was carrying it hiking or camping, I would not use that bottle opener or that can opener. If I was in that big of a pinch to open a can, I would use the knife and I would hack my way into that can. I'd rarely ever, probably, yeah, never drink anything that I need a bottle opener for. Maybe some people do, and that's a feature they love. I always thought it would be cool if Leatherman could come up with a way where you could pick a platform and almost pick some of the tools. You know, you don't like the can opener, swap that out. If you don't like the bit driver, swap that out. So on this side, you have the can opener, bottle opener, and the removable bits. This is the one that comes with it. You only get one. So them fold up. Pocket clip is extra. I purchased that in addition to the Leatherman. This, you have the awl. Haven't really used that, but one time, I think. This large flathead, I use that all the time, but not for screws, for prying. It is a great prying tool. It's nice and thick. And it just seems like it will hold up to pretty much anything you can throw at it. So love that tool. That little flathead is basically useless to me also. I have never used that, but you guys may be different. You do have your needle nose, your bigger pliers here. You have some wire cutters with both heavy gauge cutters at the bottom and lighter gauge at the top. You have a little crimper there, which this sucker can cut some really thick wire. I've tried it and it does. I've been two-handed on this reefing on some heavy gauge wire. I barely nicked those bottom cutters, and it probably was way too thick of stuff for this, but I got through it, and that's what you want your Leatherman for. As you can see, these are replaceable cutter heads. I'm not sure why Leatherman is doing this, if it's for their benefit or if part of their warranty is considering these consumables now. I'm not sure. I have not read the warranty. But I wouldn't doubt if these interchangeable saw blades and file and the cutters are considered a consumable part and thus requires the end user to replace them at their own cost. I probably won't double check it until I break one of them and need to replace them. But all that being said, I am not disappointed at all with this. Like I said, I did buy this pocket clip extra because I do carry it in my back pocket of my jeans. It is a lot of added weight. For me, the added weight, the usefulness of the tool far exceeds the hindrance of the extra weight. Some of you may think otherwise, and that is fine. They have lots of tools on there to choose from. Or you can run it in their sheath that comes with it. For me, I am not someone to wear something on my belt. That's just not, I do not like wearing anything on my belt. The reviews that I seen before I purchased this tool, people were complaining about the belt loop size available. They did not fit their belts. They didn't like the overall size of the sheath, meaning how boxy it was. It's a decent sheath, I suppose, if you know, nothing. I kind of like the old Leatherman sheaths. You know, maybe that's just not the look and popular. Maybe it's, this is more tactical looking, if you will. Even though this would not be, in my mind, a tactical tool, but that's kind of what resembles this in my eyes. I don't really have anything against it. I don't know if I would choose this one or buy a different one. There's several aftermarket sheaths available from third parties, and there are leather holsters available from Leatherman also. I think they run somewhere around $50, I believe. So that's enough on that. I did purchase the bit set from Leatherman. I keep these in my wallet since I'm not running a sheath. These are an indispensable add-on addition to the tool. You have pretty much everything you could ever need. I carry these right inside my wallet, along with that little pouch and whatever, either the saw or the file that I'm not using, and they just ride along in there, and it doesn't bother me at all. I'm kind of used to a bulky wallet, so yeah, no big deal to me. On this file, this side does have the diamond, more of a sharpening for your knives. This side is a, I would say, mid-aggressive file, kind of wood and metal. I've used it on both. And then this little clip right here pops out. And it is rather tough to pop out. This thing folds open, and there your tool blade just pops out. I've seen some videos of guys modifying or using a specific type of jigsaw blade in these, which I'm going to investigate further myself in the future. Just haven't had time yet. I'll get back to you on that if I end up finding that useful. If I had to do it again, I probably would do stainless. This finish resembles more of like a blued finish you would find on a gun, a pistol, or a rifle. In the first week I had it, it arrived to me very oily, which is understandable and fine. They don't want anything rusting, obviously, when your brand new tool shows up. It took about a week of, you know, wiping it down a few times and just using it and getting your hands filthy black and oily several times to wear that off. That finish is kind of fading around the wear points of the tool. I'm not sure what that will be like in, you know, years from now, but we will find out. But yeah, so I would probably do stainless. Other than that, I would purchase this tool in a heartbeat. Again, it is a tool. That's what it is. It's a heavy duty tool, and I find it very useful. Almost, it would be hard to go without one after having this. I do have the Leatherman Wave. I just purchased this in addition to that one. I don't have anything against that one. I love that one. It is a lot lighter. Still a great tool. I like knives and I like tools. So I got this one and I'm running it for now. So on my board behind me, I put up a few of the key points. You can check out Leatherman if you want further information, but so they're claiming it has, well, they're not claiming, it does have 21 tools. Some of those are more, you know, this tool can do that sort of thing. Like the ruler function on that. And I didn't go through everything on this. I just went through the useful stuff. This ruler along the edge here, you probably can't see it since this one is a little dark. It comes in useful once in a while. I have used it a few times since owning the tool. More of like a measure, a piece of hose or a fitting in the store when you don't have tape handy or something like that. So it's nice to have. Anything further than that probably would be not very practical. So the 21 tools, it is available in stainless or black. The sheath that we went over, it is black nylon. The primary blade length is 3.1 inches, 7.87 centimeters. The closed length of the tool is 4.5 inches, 11.5 centimeters. The weight on the tool is 12.5. I measured it in this configuration with the pocket clip, and it is 12.6. So that pocket clip does add a 0.1 of an ounce heavier. That is 335 grams. The stainless version is 420 stainless steel, and the black version is black oxide. Not sure if that is stainless steel with black oxide over it. Not that important to me. So I showed you the bit that was included with the Phillips and the flathead. 25-year warranty is what Leatherman is saying on their website. I have not read the details and and the details on the warranty. And I probably won't until I need it, which then we'll find that out later. The price as of now is June 6th of 20. It says the retail price was $129.95, and that was cut down to $114.95. The optional bit set that I purchased was $24. A replacement saw and file set is $10. The pocket clip and lanyard ring is $5 to $6. I think that pretty much covers it. Like I said, I would definitely recommend this tool to anybody that wants a heavy duty Leatherman to ride along with them. So probably will do another review later on, maybe years down the road, when this thing is beat and battered from years of hard use, and see how she's still holding up. And if I have any problems with it, I will definitely do a follow-up video on what happens with the warranty when that happens. So that'll do it for this one, guys. We will see you on the next one. Take care.